I'm almost 83 years old. What the heck can they do to me? If I died, so what? I mean, there's really nothing that can be done to me. So I'm willing to step into the fire, and there is a fire, and I am stepping into it. I know in my heart of hearts that I am doing everything in my human power to address the climate crisis. When people unite and are organized, they can win. And we have done that so many times in my experience over the last 50, 60 years that I can't help but be hopeful. Those 4 months in Washington, D.C., wearing red and having a rally every Friday and engaging in civil disobedience, every Friday, two-thirds of the people there were women. Most of them were older women. And I think this is very important. With age, you become more confident. You learn to step into your skin and own your space. It took me a long time, into my 60s, before I could really own myself fully. And that should be a good thing for people who are watching this. You know, it's never too late. Don't give up. Don't settle or give up too soon. Because if you keep working at it, you can become who you were meant to be later in life. In fact, it's much easier later on. It's much harder to be young than it is to be old, let me tell you. Women are much less vulnerable to the disease of individualism. We understand interdependence. We tend to like being in community. I mean, look at book clubs and quilting bees and sewing bees and all the way back to the times of hunter-gatherers. Women find their strength, their superpower together. And that's why I think women are leading the climate movement against the climate crisis. And I just want to acknowledge that and applaud it.